Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell. Now we're going to go back and address an issue that we talked about in podcast 767. Got two notes, one from Rene, one from Dennis, and they said, you know, hey, you missed the really obvious thing, and I'm great at missing the obvious thing. Back in 767, we had a data set that looked like this, and on another worksheet, they had set up a formula that was basically copying that data. And so I'll just choose equal B2 here. And the original data set is fairly sparse. So what we're getting is, of course, lots of places the numbers are showing up. So there's the 9, but everywhere else we were getting a 0. And in that question, they said that they had rewritten this to put quote instead of zeros. Someone said, well, you know, that's the long way around. Why don't you just go to Tools, Option, and on the View tab, there's a setting that says we're going to show zero values. If we uncheck that, then sure enough, the data on the copied worksheet, where all the formulas are, looks just like it did on the original sheet. All the places where there's no value and we're getting a zero, we're just simply getting a blank to appear there. And the beautiful thing is that there's not any text in there. So if we would build a formula that would refer to a couple of cells, it's going to work perfectly. Or if we would build the autosum formula out there, it's going to work perfectly as well, all the way through. Now, the one downside to this is it affects every cell in your spreadsheet. So if you had another section where you really wanted zeros to appear, well, they're not going to appear. But in many cases, that Tools, Options, View, Uncheck Zeros is a great way to go. Thanks to Rene and Dennis for sending it in. I'll be sending out an Excel master pin to both of them. And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.